Hello children, how are you all? So, in the previous video, we have come across the topic that is four-digit number. Okay children, I hope you understood in a better way. So, the four-digit number starts from where children? Yes, that is 1000. Yes, that is the smallest four-digit number. And the greatest four-digit number is... The greatest four-digit number is, yes, 9999 children. Yes, we have come across the greatest and smallest four-digit number. Other than these, we are also having few more numbers in between these two numbers. Yes, now we shall come across those numbers. So, we can form any number. We can form any four-digit number if we have four digits with us. And one more thing. In today's topic, I am going to tell you three things, that is how to form a four-digit number, how to read a four-digit number and how to represent a four-digit number on abacus. Yes, children. So, firstly, we start with our topic, that is forming a four-digit number. Yes. Children, forming a four-digit number. So, in the name itself, we can understand the number, definitely it should have four digits. Yes, it should have definitely how many digits? Four digits. In your previous class, you have come across three-digit numbers. So, you had fun with many of three-digit numbers. Now, in this chapter also, you will be having a great fun with the four-digit numbers. Yes. So, to form a four-digit number, definitely we should have four digits. Okay, now for example we can consider any four digits. Okay children, yes, I am taking 2, 4, 8 and 6. Okay children, for now I am taking 2, 4, 8 and 6. These four separate digits I am taking and I am making a four digit number which has a value. Okay, now I am making a four digit number. Now you write all the numbers together. Okay, now you write all the numbers together and then here you are going to get a four digit number. Okay children, yes, 2, 4, 8 and 6. Okay, 2, 4, 8 and 6, this becomes a four digit number. Okay, by using these separate four digits we get a four digit number. In the same way, not only these digits, we can also use many other digits to make a four digit number. And one thing children, one thing you need to keep in your mind, that is, yes, now you have to listen carefully children, while making a four digit number, definitely you should start with any number but not with zero. The number should not start with zero children. Yes, you will be, if I ask you to write a four digit number using 0, 1, 5 and 7. If I ask you to frame a number 0 by using the digits 0, 1, 5 and 7. You will be telling directly, you will be writing a number 0, 1, 5, 7 and that is completed. No children, it is not correct because 0 doesn't have any value. If I offer your friend two chocolates and I am giving you nothing, you will be raising a question definitely, teacher, why you are not offering me the chocolates. Yes, if I give you 0, then you will be raising a question in the same way, because 0 doesn't have any value. So we can't start a number using 0 children. So here you can't write a 4 digit number starting with 0. Definitely the number should start with any, the four digit number should start with any other number but not zero. This thing you need to keep in your mind children when you form a four digit number. Yes, so instead of taking the zero, firstly you can skip that. Okay, you need not take zero first. You can put the zero in any other place. Okay, so first, now I'm changing the number, now I'm taking one first and I'm writing 0 next. So here is our number, that is 1, 0, 5, and 7. 1, 0, 5, and 7. Okay, children. Now formation of numbers. Formation of numbers is very much easy when you have, when you understand how to frame a number by knowing the tips and the important points you need to keep in your mind. The thing I have already told you, you should not start with the zero, children. Okay, any number you can use and any type of value you can give, but it should start with any other number but not zero. This is how you form a 4-digit number, children. So now I'll be drawing few pictures. For each picture I'll be giving some value. Okay, for each picture I'll be giving some value. Based upon that value you need to form a number. Which number? What is our topic? Yes, 4-digit number only you need to form. You should not form any other. Okay, definitely you need to form a 4-digit number by seeing the pictures. I hope you enjoy that. So let us move forward. Okay, children. Now what shall we take? Yes, we shall take one fruit. Firstly, I am taking apple. For this apple, I am considering one apple, not only one. For apple, I am considering as 1000. Okay, one apple I am considering as 1000. Okay, next I am taking mango. For this mango, I am considering it as 100. Okay, 100. I am considering it as 100. Next, I'm going to take one ball. Yes, you'll be playing with ball, right? So I'm taking one ball. So here, for this ball, I'm considering the value 10. Okay? This is 1000, this is 100, this is 10. Now, one more. I'm taking one bat. Yes, you'll be playing with bat and ball, right? So for this bat, I'm considering it as 1. Right? Yes, children. Now, these pictures, you just keep in your mind. Based on these pictures, you need to answer me. You need to form a 4-digit number. So, how many pictures I consider? You need to count the pictures and you need to tell me the number. Now, I am taking 3 apples. How many? I am taking 3 apples. I am taking 2 mangoes. If summer, children, you love mangoes, right? So I'm taking 2 mangoes here. Okay, next I'm not at all taking any balls. Okay, here I'm putting nothing. Directly I'm taking one bat. Now count and tell me the number, children. 3 apples I'm taking. 1, 2, 3. So here the number will be 3. Okay, now next, how many mangoes I'm taking? 2. Yes, very good. 1 and 2 mangoes. Yes, very good. Here I am taking nothing. Here I am taking nothing. So, here I am putting nothing means, if I give you nothing, you will be telling. Yes, that is nothing but 0, children. Yes, very good. That is 0. Now, I am taking 1 bat. So, the value will be 1. So, here we are having 4 digits. 3, 2, 0, 1. So, the answer is 3201. Here is our 4-digit number. So by seeing the pictures, how many pictures we are taking, based upon the pictures we are framing a number. Okay, children. Now next, so now we have understood, by seeing the pictures you are framing the number, how to frame the 4-digit number. Now on abacus instrument, how we have to frame. So now on abacus instrument, how we have to represent the numbers. Or I'll be drawing the abacus instrument, children. So you need to count the beats and you need to tell the value. Yes? Yes. Come on. We shall draw. So as our number is a 4-digit number, so we need to take 4 lines, right? So I'm taking 4 lines. So here I'll be taking 3 beads. 4 beads I'm taking. Okay. Now here I'm taking 2 beads. Here I am taking 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Here I am taking 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, children, by seeing these beads, you need to count. By seeing these beggars, you need to count the beads and you need to tell the value. Okay? Firstly, we shall count. We shall start counting from here. 1, 2, 3, and 4. 4 beads. So the value is 4. Okay, now here. 1 and 2. Yes, the value is 2. Next. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. The value is 5. Yes, very good. Next. 1, 2, 3, and 4. The value is 4. Here is our 4 digit number. What it is? 4254. What is the number, children? 4000. Repeat along with me. 4254. So 4 digits are there, right? Yes, 4 digits. 1, 2, 3, and 4. It is a 4 digit number. Okay, 4254. So in this way, by counting the beads on each line, you need to write the number. Okay, children? So one more example I'll be giving you. So you need to tell me the answer. Answer that. Yes. So now we need to count the beads present in the first line. Yes. We shall start counting. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. Yes. 6. The value is 6. Very good. 6. 6 beads. And here nothing is there. So if there is nothing, we need to consider it as what, children? Yes. 0. If there is nothing, 0. Yes. Next. How many beads are here? 1, 2, 3. 3 beads are here. So the value is 3. Yes, very good. Now how many are here? 1. Yes. Now here we go. Here is our 4 digit number. That is 6000. Here we are having nothing. So 6031. 6031 is our 4 digit number. What is our 4 digit number? 6031. 6031 is our 4 digit number. So this is how you need to find out or you need to form a 4 digit number by seeing the pictures or by using 4 digits, 4 different digits, by using 4 different digits and by seeing the pictures and their value and on the abacus instrument also you can form 4 digit numbers, children. Okay. This is forming 4 digit number. Now our next topic is reading 4 digit number. How to read a 4 digit number? So how to read a 4 digit number, we shall come to know now. Okay, now reading a 4 digit number. Okay, children? So, in your previous class, you know how to read the number names. Yes, children? You know how to read number names. You are having number names. You know, you have by hearted your number names. Okay? Up to 100, anyhow, you will be knowing all the number names. So, reading a 4-digit number is in the same way. It is very simple. And the thing, in the previous class, you started reading from 100. Starting from 100. Yes. Here our 4 digit number starts from which value? What is the word we need to use? Okay. This is the first time you are going to learn and it will be very easy to understand and you can also remember it very easily, children. So here I will be taking any number. Okay. We can consider any of the number and we shall read that number. Okay. Yes. I am taking 6, 3, 5, 2. Okay. How to read this one? Okay, so in previous class, for example, you just observe these 3 digits. Okay, anyhow, you will be knowing this 352. So this will be the ones value, tens and hundreds. So you will be start reading from 3. 352. Yes, you will be answering me 352. Yes, children, in the same way, now you are introduced with a new digit, that is fourth digit, and the place for this is called 1000. Okay, children? Yes, the place for this is 1000. Yes, it is a higher value. It's like it's a higher value, children. So you need to start reading from this higher value, highest place value, children. So here you need to start, that is 6, no? So 6 means 6000. What is the next value? 3. Yes, 3. 6000. 300. Yes, 3 is in hundreds place, right? So 6300. And next, what is this number? 5. So 5 is not written, 5 should be written as 5 or what else? Yes, 5 should not be written as 5 because it is not in ones place. So it should be written as 50. Yes, it should be written as 50. 50. What is the last number, children? 2. Yes, 52. Okay, so here reading a 4-digit number, we are starting reading it from the left side, children. You should start reading from the left side. You should not read from the right side, children. So you can see you need to start reading from the left side. Yes, you need to start reading from the highest place value, that is thousands. So the four digit number, the highest place is 1000, children. So we need to start reading from the left side. Okay, that is 6352. Okay, we shall go through one more example so that you can understand in a better way. Yes, one more number we should take. I am taking 2763. Now you need to tell me how I have to write this. Yes, yes. I should say 200. 200, is that correct? No. So children, I have taken a different number now. So now I'll be telling you one more method. So here, that is writing the place values, children. So it will be easy for you to remember. Okay? Yes. Now in the previous class, in your second class, you have known that ones, tens, and hundreds places. So here we are introducing only thousands place. So here we shall write. On the above number, we shall write ones, tens, hundreds, and for thousand, we represent it as TH, children. Thousands place is represented as TH. Okay, children? The shortcut is TH. If I write TH, that is nothing but thousand. Okay? So ones, tens, hundreds, thousands. So we shall start reading from where? From here or here? Yes, from here we need to read. Okay, so what is the value here? 2763. Okay, children, now this is how you need to form, you need to read a number, you need to read a 4-digit number. So in this video we have come across forming a 4-digit number and how to read a 4-digit number. Okay, you just go through the exercise and definitely you will be doing good. So in the next video, I'll be telling you place value and face value, children. Hope you enjoy the video. Thank you. Have a nice day.